Hello. Nomad's Cut, efficient and quick, part 4. It's about creating blades. A sword blade, an axe blade, and so on. Let's go to like this. Delete this one. Perspective off and reset the view. We need for an axe blade, no. Start with a sword blade. We need a box. Reduce the topology to 1. And now you can adjust your thickness of the sword a little bit. And look at the left side. The Y division changed. Turn it to 1. 1 is okay. And you can scale it in this direction. Yes, you can keep it a little smaller. It's only a demonstration how it works. Okay, now you can validate it. And you can use symmetry. Activate the, not the set, the Y plane. And you use a move brush. With a move brush, you can make the top of the sword symmetry is on. You can here scale it like this. In the left view, you can adjust it here a little bit. And the next step is go in a side view, left view, use a cell mask. Symmetry off. No, not this cell mask, sorry. Rectangular. And mask these points at the side, like this. And check the cell mask front vertex that both sides are selected. With the gizmo, you can now scale in the blades, the sharp edges of the sword, like this. And you can clear the mask now, swipe up, and now you can adjust the length of the sword. Okay. Here's a tip when you want to adjust the inside of the sword. Now you have a real low poly count. And with this low poly count, it's possible to mask everything real quick. I use the cell mask, the lasso tool, and I mask the mid part here. Like this, and you can sharpen it one time. And now you can paint it. You can paint the blade and invert the mask and so on. And you can also adjust with a gizmo. You can use a flat subdivision and the mask stays. And now you can use the gizmo. I go in this view. And you can now adjust it a little bit. And you can invert the mask and do things like this. Okay. And with the move tool, I think, yes, the plane works fine. Symmetry on. With a move tool, you can adjust your sword like this. And you can use a subdivision again and. Yeah, do crazy things with the sword. Like you want. That you got such a blade. Okay, this is the sword blade. I delete this one. And X blade you can create with a plane. Reduce the topology, make it real low. Three is okay. And validate the object. You can use the trim function. Make sure hole filling is off. And use the lasso tool, symmetry off. And here you can trim now a quarter of your blade. And when you're fine. And you can use the split function. Here, when you use the split tool, make sure hole filling is off. And use the lasso tool. You can here create a blade, a sharp edge for the blade. And now you can use the symmetry. Sorry, I show the line. Sorry. We have to simple match the object again. And here use the symmetry. And left to the right, yes. And change the symmetry to this one. And right to the left. Oh, wrong. Left to the right. And here you can adjust it a little bit, shrink it or scale it. And it's, yes, you have so many possible ways to adjust it with a move brush and so on. And now when you're fine, use the mask, mask everything. And extracted shell thickness 1. 1 is okay. And now we use the cell mask. And mask apart, lasso tool. Like this. It's okay, only one side, we can mirror it again. And let's test it, what happens. I think we got to unmask some parts. The radius is too big. And now invert the mask, use the gizmo and make the blade sharp. Like this. I hope we got everything, yes. And the first plane we can delete. Now we got a sharp edge and we can now swipe and clear the mask. And yes, when you're fine, you can use a subdivision and smooth it again a little bit. Or adjust it a little bit more. And use the symmetry, left to the right, yes. Then are both sides with a sharp edge. Okay, that's it. Have fun with sculpting. Ciao.